Describing my style of music is pretty difficult because I've had so many different influences, but I would definitely say that there's a definite nod to the past, quite nostalgic references. Billie Holiday, Peggy Lee, Etta James, Dinah Washington, all the kind of great queens of tragedy. I've adopted also the look of the past. I've been dressing like in old clothes, like from the 40s and 50s for about 5 or 6 years now. Usually I spend a lot of my time in thrift stores, vintage clothes shops and all that, eBay, just hunting around for like gems. But tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be wearing a dress which was made for me by a girl called Conchita Perez, and she's been making it for like a month, and it's so beautiful. It's like the best thing I've ever worn. I'm quite excited. Subject matter that I kind of concentrate on, it's all about reflecting on the things you've done or the things you haven't done. It's sort of quite sad sometimes, but there are happy songs, but it's supposed to be kind of like reflective of life. Everybody is content sometimes and other times we're not, and I think a lot of music that comes out of the present, that comes from the perspective of like everything's wonderful and light and lovely, especially in pop, and I don't think it is always wonderful and light and lovely. Two songs that spring straight to mind about being memorable for me. One is Love Ya, which is probably, I think, my most fun, kind of light-hearted, catchy song in my view, and I really enjoy singing it, and it's not about it's a nice breather from all the heaviness that I think about, so it's quite light-hearted, but in a kind of new culture where it's a bit of a knock at people who say I love ya, because I think that it means absolutely nothing if you say that, and it's like text language, so it's a bit of a kind of like two fingers up to making that word seem so cheap. The other one is The Bloody Flower, which is about, you know, women that I know who've struggled a lot and done a lot of things by themselves, particularly kind of like single mothers and women who've had rubbish relationships and like the strength of women, so it's got a quite a feminist angle to it. The bloody flower grips from the root, she wavers in the wind, but we'll always stand and salute. You can try to pick her up from the ground, men have tried, but her bleeding stems from pain. In strength her heart has cried, counting her tears. That the people I admire and who I aspire to have careers like are like people like Bjork, people like Erykah Badu, Jill Scott, Nick Cave, Tom Waits, like all these sort of people who are, have done something, they've taken a risk and gone for something that nobody else has done and not said the obvious. Like, I've created my own nights myself because I'm not kind of like waiting to be approached. I'm doing this all, it's like homegrown, home cooked stuff. And I'm not ashamed to kind of ask, because you don't get it if you don't ask. She's lost her feeling in her head, paralyzed from her heart down. If I could collaborate with anyone in my wildest dreams, it'd be Andre 3000. Because I think that he's hit my nail right on the head. First and foremost, and then I used to like copy records and copy singers at home, but I was never confident enough to sing in public. So it wasn't until maybe 4 years ago that I actually plucked up the courage to sing in front of an audience. I don't know what turned. Basically, I was just sweeping up glass in a bar I was working in one day, and somebody heard me singing along to a CD and asked if I'd be in their band. So I did. My aim in music is to be big. I don't want to sit down and be like just some little cult figure. I'm not sure if I'd cope with that, being recognised in the street very well, but I definitely want to be a household name on the side of soup cans and stuff.